Get ready to match the stars. Sheldon Leonard, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Louisa Moritz, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rutter.
I'm Big Eddie. He's Big Eddie. Thank you, Johnny Olsen and friends.
How are you?
Nice to have you back. Nice to have you back. And nice to have you back. And you, and you, and you. How could we do it without you? I ask you, how could we do it without you?
How could you do it without
you? We couldn't. No, here's what we're going to do. We're going to say hello to Carol Bartos and Rick Latini. You were tuned in last time we were together. You realize that this young lady became our all-time big money winner when she achieved $20,850. How do you feel?
Fantastic. My house has been a madhouse.
Your house has been a madhouse?
Yes. My mother ran home and called everybody she knew, and they all called me this morning.
Yes.
And it's terrific.
Are they helping you spend the money?
Well, you know what's the nicest thing for me is I haven't had a car, and I've had to, every time I needed to go somewhere, call someone and say, can you give me a ride? Oh. And now I can call them and say, can I give you a lift?
Oh, how nice. Challenged by this young fella here. Rick, we're meeting him for the first time, and we'll ask him to tell us a little bit about himself.
Okay, I'm a teacher. I live in Sherman Oaks, and my wife's going to have our first baby in 3 weeks.
3 weeks. That's very nice. We wish you well.
Thank you.
What do you teach, Rick?
I teach a 4th, 5th, and 6th grade.
4th, 5th, and 6th grade?
Mm-hmm. At the same time.
That's an interesting challenge, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you'll find this an interesting challenge, too, and we'll start that in a minute or so, but right now, let's do this. Ready? Here we go. Bing. Push a button, reveal our first round questions, ask Rick to make a selection.
I'll take B for baby.
B for baby. 3 weeks for him and his wife. Here it is. When Fat Phyllis waddled into the computer dating service, they took one look at Fat Phyllis, and they said, forget about a man, Fat Phyllis. We're matching you up with a blank. Everybody writes. Fat Phyllis, computer dating service. Forget about a man, Fat Phyllis. We're matching you up with a blank. Okay, that's very good. You didn't forget how to do it, did you?
No, yeah.
Terrific. All right. What have you been doing since we saw you last time?
Oh, I did 4 movies. I did One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, starring Jack Nicholson. Don't ask me, because I'll take over the whole show.
No, you won't.
I got it.
What are you wearing there? Is that an Indian headdress?
It's called a bird of prey.
It's a bird of prey?
Take one look at her bird and you...
Yeah. All right, here we go. Now, Rick, are you ready? Here it is.
Okay.
Fat Phyllis waddled into the computer dating service, and they took one look at her and said, forget about a man, Fat Phyllis. We're matching you up with a...
hippopotamus.
A hippopotamus. Good answer.
Good answer.
He could be in show business, right, Sheldon?
Yes, he could be in a menagerie, too.
What did you say?
Well, I'm menagerie-oriented as well.
Elephant is good. Hippopotamus is good. Any large animal will do here. Brett?
Well, now, hippopotamus is a terrific answer. There's no question about it. Now, I just have to get mine up here. Now, I said a very nice, good-looking whale.
Yes. Whale is another large mammal. Yes, Charles?
Another elephant, I'm sorry, Rick.
Two elephants and a whale so far. Two elephants and a whale. He's looking for a hippopotamus. What do you say, Louisa?
Well, I don't think we have those in Cuba.
What?
But
Whales?
Hippopotamus.
You don't have hippopotamuses in Whale?
No.
Hippopotami.
I'm messing with a hip.
Hippos in Cuba. All right, Richard.
Well, because Betty White, you know, has trained us all to be nice to animals.
That's right. Be kind to
animals. She hasn't trained me.
The lady, what's her name? Fat Phyllis?
Fat Phyllis, right.
I wanted her to have something large that wouldn't talk back, so I said a blimp.
A blimp. Forget about a man, Fat Phyllis. We're matching you up with a hippo, according to Rick.
I know, according to him. Boy, I said blimp, unfortunately.
Two blimps. Two blimps, one hippo, two elephants, and one whale. All right, now we've got this for you, Carol. Your first rounder goes like so. Isadora kicked the vacuum cleaner salesman out of her house after he turned on the machine and sucked her blank into the bag. She kicked the vacuum cleaner salesman out of her house after he turned on the machine and sucked her blank into the bag. She's trying to sell her a vacuum cleaner, you see.
I'm all finished.
All right. She kicked him out, you see.
She kicked him out.
She got angry with him. He turned on this machine and sucked your blank into the bag. Everybody ready up here? All right, Sheldon's got his answer. Okay. Now, we come to Carol. Isadora kicked the vacuum cleaner salesman clear out of the house after he turned on the machine and sucked her blank into the bag.
I think this is terrible. That's a bust.
The audience doesn't like her answer, and it's rather painful to think about it. Because that must have been a 12-horsepower engine. She said sucked her bust into the bag. That's what she said. What do you say, Sheldon?
The name Isadora set in memory train.
Oh, yeah.
Relating to Isadora.
That's right. Isadora Duncan killed when she was riding in an automobile and her scarf trailed out and got talked around the Seven Veils. Yeah. That's right. Okay. Very obtuse
literary,
answer.
But,
yes.
Yeah. Of no use to you.
Don't get fancy with us, Sheldon. What do you say?
Yeah, that's what I say.
Yeah.
I say, hey, sucked her wig in it.
Sucked her wig into the bag. That's a good one. Very good. What do you say, Charles?
I said panty or pantyhose, depending on what day it was.
That's another powerful machine, I tell you. Holy mackerel. What do you say, Louisa?
Well, he was mad, so he's like their head in
it. He wasn't mad. She was mad.
Oh, but they were both mad.
Now, will you listen to me, Louisa, when I read these questions and pay attention to what's going on here?
Otherwise,
I'm going to have to shoot down your bird of paradise or whatever that is.
It'll bite.
Oh, it will bite? Okay. I'll keep my distance. What do you say, Richard?
I thought the wig got
the
sucked
wig.
In.
The wig got sucked in her thing. Okay. Isadora kicked the vacuum cleaner salesman out of their house after he turned down the machine and sucked her blank into the bag, and Carol said bust. What do you say?
Well, I said dress.
Her dress. Okay. Yeah. So it's 1-0 in favor of Rick at the end of round one. Round two coming up after this message. Round one is finished. 1-0 in favor of our challenger. Round two coming up. Challenger, make your selection.
I'll stick with B.
B it is. Everybody plays except Louisa. Except Louisa.
Now,
doesn't that come as a surprise?
That's right.
She thought she was in the dummy seat.
Yeah. That's usually the dummy seat then. No, I'm only kidding about that. At the restaurant, one fly said to the other, hey, there's a blank in my soup. At the restaurant, one fly, two flies are talking, you see, in this restaurant. One fly said to the other, hey, there's a blank in my soup.
I want to make sure this is right.
Hello, darling. Very nice to see you.
Is everybody ready up there?
Little blue-eyed devil.
All right. Put it in the slot. We come over here to Rick Latini. Rick, at the restaurant, one fly said to another, he says, hey, There's a blank in my soup.
A spoon.
Two flies are talking, you see.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have a talk with you later, Rick. Sheldon, what do you say?
Well, I'll tell you, the problem I had with the previous contestants was that I was getting too intellectual about the whole thing.
That's right. Now you dummied up a little, right?
Dummied up a little. I figures what's going to happen to a fly in a soup. All of a sudden, he looks around and he says to his friend, "Hey, look what this. There's a spoon in my soup."
Ah! I don't understand the whole thing.
Maybe they are not so dumb after all.
What did you say?
I don't know. Good gravy, Marie.
Really
I didn't
surprised.
Come close to spoon.
What'd
I
you
said
say?
There's a man in my soup.
I think the audience is with us there. Now, you know the old joke. There's a guy looks around, he says to the waiter, "Hey, waiter, there's a fly in my soup." And then he says, "Well, don't worry, he's not going
to
drink much." Or what's he doing there? He's doing
drink,
the backstroke or whatever. Yeah. So the
Bob Martin.
But.
Person.
A person, certainly. Now, Richard, I'm sure you understand it.
Well, the trouble with me, I've been going to it too intellectually. And like a yo-yo.
Yeah.
Yeah, like a yo-yo, I'm still going that way. I put man.
You put man. Now, Fanny.
Yes, did you hear about the two grasshoppers that met each other?
No.
Okay. No, this grasshopper met an ant, and the ant said, "Hey, did you know they named a drink after you?" To the grasshopper, and the grasshopper said, "Oh, is there a drink called Harold?" I said, "Person."
Hey, person. That was the answer. Carol, again, you're in a good spot here. 2-3 Marvin said, "Dr. Quackenbush is a swell psychiatrist. Instead of lying on top of his couch, he lets me lie on top of his blank." That's what Marvin said. Marvin said that. Dr. Quackenbush, he is some swell psychiatrist. Instead of getting me to lie on top of his couch, he lets me lie on top of his blank. Got the idea.
Do you have his address?
That's good, sweetheart.
Yes,
like
very good.
And I resented you looking straight at me with those psychiatrist jokes.
No.
Oh, yes, you
go.
That's like
that.
Look right up like
this. Nothing wrong with going to a psychiatrist. Yes, indeed.
I think you're trying to suggest something to me.
All right. I'll put that in the slot there, and it's all set to carry on. Okay.
Oh, that's a good one, Louisa.
Very good. All right, here we go. Carol. Marvin said, "Dr. Quackenbush is a swell psychiatrist. Instead of lying on top of his couch, he lets me lie on top of his..."
Bed?
Bed? Why are you applauding? Why are you applauding? That's a dumb answer.
Well, I don't know.
You ever been to a psychiatrist's office? Oh. Well, maybe that may be the answer. I don't think they have beds in psychiatrists' office. They have the couches where the people lie down, leather usually. What do you say, Sheldon?
He works out of his home.
Stay out of it.
He ain't got a bed there.
What do you say?
Well, my answer is a romantic answer. It's about as romantic as I could get on this medium television, but...
Laugh. Okay. There's one. And Brett?
Well, you thought that was a dumb answer, right?
Yep.
Who was it you used to say you ain't heard nothing yet? I said, got on top of her hat rack.
You know. Oh. I'm with you.
You want to see a woman of 40 blank years old cry?
You really do need medical attention. An answer like that. Charles?
I said nurse.
Nurse!
And if we don't reread the question, we won't have to retape it.
That's right. Dr. Quackenbush is a swell psychiatrist. Instead of lying on top of his couch, he lets me lie on top of his, according to Carol, bed. What do you say?
I say, where was Brett last night wearing a red jacket?
Where was I last night?
I don't know.
I saw you. Anyway.
Oh, yeah, she last night.
Here, I didn't...
Water death. One for you. All right, Carol is holding her breath because she's been here a long time. She's won more money than anyone has ever won on this game, $20,850. She's got two to go here, and she needs one to tie. But if she matches both Richard and Fanny, she can win. Let's find out what happens.
I give up. Where was Brett?
She was at Joe Allen's.
How did you? Were you there, too?
I was there, too.
I said,
nurse! All right. Now, Carol, you've got to match Fanny, or we're going to have a new champion.
Oh, Carol, I had some land to sell you. I said desk.
Desk! Congratulations to you.
Well.
You've won more money, and you've been here longer than any other contestant we've had in over 2 years on the air. We congratulate you, Carol.
Thank you.
We're very happy for you.
So am I.
$20,850.
Thank you.
While she's spinning off, we'll give you this message. You hurry right back and see how he does. Here we are. Rick Latina's up here for the first time. He's got his $100 now for winning the game, and now he's going to try for over $5,000. How do you feel, Rick?
Fine, just fine.
Okay, here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank shoe. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you team up with the next one, you get $250. The bottom one gets you $100. Whom do you call on?
I'll take Sheldon.
Listen, Rick.
That's wonderful to have choreography in
this
question.
That's right.
First time.
Listen, it's my show, Rick. See, let's get that straight.
Okay.
And you do what I tell you to,
all right,
and you stand where I tell you to stand. See that hunk of tape that's glued to the rug there?
Uh-huh.
Stand on that hunk of tape.
Right.
Now, if you get off of it, I will remind you that you're off the tape. All right, who'd you call on?
Sheldon.
Sheldon, what do you say?
Horse.
Horseshoe. There's one.
Fanny.
Fanny, what do you say?
Left shoe. No, I'm just kidding.
He's just kidding.
All right, they used to call detectives this. Gumshoe.
Gumshoe, right.
Richard.
Snowshoe.
Snowshoe. Now, you've got a snowshoe, a gumshoe, and a horseshoe. Do you want one of those, or do you want to think up one of your own and make that the answer?
I think I'm take horseshoe.
Horseshoe it is. And we hope it brings you a little luck. We'll begin down at the bottom and see if the horseshoe is hiding under the $100 response. Soft shoe.
Old woman who lived in the shoe.
Let's see if the $250 response will reveal a horseshoe. Tennis shoe.
Oh, the whole world's got tennis, man. I'm bored with it now.
Tennis is a marvelous game. Don't be bored.
I don't care. I'm sick and tired of tennis coming into everything.
Yes, I know what that is.
What is that?
Bless you.
Bless you. No. I'll make a nickel side bet that horseshoe's going to be under the $500 response. Anyone?
Well, he's going to be a new father, so I hope it is.
I hope it is, too. Here we go. Slide it, Earl. Horseshoe. That's $600. Okay. Good for him. Yes, sir. Terrific. Okay, you got 600. Now you got to play for 5,000. To collect, you got to match one head-to-head exactly.
Well, I'm going to name my first boy after Richard, so I'm taking Richard.
I have nothing to do with it.
Okay. What are you going to call it if it's a girl?
Danny Brooke.
If it's a boy, it's Richard. If it's a girl, it's Danny?
Danny Brooke.
Well, that's one name, Danny Brooke? Is it?
Oh,
that's
Danny
a pretty name.
Brooke.
Oh, Danny Brooke. Oh, no. Okay, here we go. For $5,000, you face me. Just turn around a little bit. Thank you. Cole blank. That's C-O-L-E.
Oh.
C-O-L-E blank. All right, he's finished. He made up his mind very quickly. We ask you to make a decision now which you think will match his. What do you say, Rick? Cole blank. C-O-L-E blank.
The only thing I can think of is Cole Porter.
Cole Porter. Okay. All right. He says that'll match you for $5,000. Richard, what do you say?
I think it's coleslaw.
Coleslaw. Coleslaw.
Is it cold?
Cold. Is that the way you spell? You know, I can't think of how you spell cold. Is that the way you spell coleslaw?
Coleslaw.
That's right.
Cold.
All right, listen, Rick, you didn't get that, but you got the $600. You're going to play another game, but right now, this message for you. Here we go. Gene Rayburn Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Travel Tales next over most of these CBS stations.